వివిధ రంగాలలో స్టార్టప్ కంపెనీలను ఆంధ్రప్రదేశ్లో అభివృద్ధి చేయడానికి మేక్ ఇన్ ఏపీ కార్యక్రమం ఎంతగానో ఉపయోగపడుతుందని మంత్రి నారా లోకేష్ తెలిపారు. అమరావతిలోని మేక్ ఇన్ ఏపీ కార్యక్రమాన్ని మంత్రి నారా లోకేష్ ప్రారంభించారు. ఈ సందర్భంగా ఆయన మాట్లాడుతూ నూతన ఆవిష్కరణలు రాబోయే కాలంలో దేశ ప్రగతిని నిర్దేశించబోతున్నాయని, నూతన ఆవిష్కరణలకు వేదిక అవుతున్న దేశాలు వేగంగా అభివృద్ధి చెందుతున్నాయని అన్నారు. అలాగే అనేక నూతన ఉద్యోగ అవకాశాలు వస్తున్నాయని, ఇప్పుడు ఉన్న బిజినెస్ మోడల్స్ అనేక సవాళ్లను ఎదుర్కొంటున్నాయని స్పష్టం చేశారు. నూతన ఆవిష్కరణల వల్ల వ్యాపారాలలో విప్లవాత్మక మార్పులు వస్తున్నాయని, ఒక సొంత కారు కూడా లేని ఓలా దేశంలో అతిపెద్ద కార్ సర్వీస్ ప్రొవైడింగ్ కంపెనీగా మారిందని అన్నారు. ఒక సొంత రూమ్ కూడా లేని ఓయో దేశంలో అతిపెద్ద హోటల్ సర్వీస్ ప్రొవైడింగ్ కంపెనీగా ఎదిగిందని తెలియజేశారు. రాష్ట్ర విభజన తరువాత రాష్ట్రంలో స్టార్టప్ కంపెనీల అభివృద్ధికి అనేక చర్యలు తీసుకుంటున్నామని తెలిపారు. ఇన్నోవేషన్ వ్యాలీ ఏర్పాటు చేసి నూతన ఆవిష్కరణలు ప్రతి ఒక్కరి జీవితంలో భాగంగా ఉండాలి అనే లక్ష్యంతో ఈ కార్యక్రమాలు రూపొందిస్తున్నామని తెలిపారు. Thank you. So we move forward. I would like to give you all a small insight about Mek in AP. Established corporates and industry mentors to build industry and academic partnership. And proceedings, may I now request Sri Vini Patro, CEO, AP Innovation Society, to please give his welcome address. Ladies and gentlemen, to speak few words about AP Innovation Society.
With one of the major initiatives that we're taking up are from, there are plenty of problems that we'll be able to address. Most of the products and most of the innovations happen to be around the rural consumer. The opportunity that we have as a country, you know, having said that, we have a matter of time. It's about innovators start looking at these consumer local problems and trying to solve it. I think it's going to be one of the major things that are going to happen, and we believe that such initiative is then we were talking about it. The NASCOM and well campaign has activities of challenges they need to solve and also limits. You know, when you actually give them a time frame in a competition for 48 hours or 36 hours, we've seen score. With that, today's I think event is about launching of this Make AP. We do have Q&A and interaction between the audience and the panel after the inaugural session is over. With that,
for IoT and AI, I advise that to nurture startup in IoT.
System was not about building these fancy accelerators and incubators. In fact, when I was talking to Sanjeev ji, that's what I was telling him. I said, sir, you know, in India, if you look at all the companies, all the unicorns that we are today talking about, they didn't come from these fancy places. Even globally, if you take a look at it, all great startups did not come from fancy incubators or accelerators, but in fact, they came from colleges. All of them came from colleges, and that is where I believe that all the representatives from various colleges play a very, very important role today. You know, as a state, the mandate for us is to do a monthly hackathon. Vinny is yet to come to speed, but we assure you that in 3 months' time from monthly, we actually want to go through a weekly rigor. I believe month is too long, and you know, every week, it should be thematic. We're going to have 52 teams in the state. We're going to pre-announce these teams. We are now building a statewide hackathon platform where students like you can actually present your ideas. You can build your teams. Then we will do the extra effort of actually connecting you to the mentor network, to connecting you to the venture capitalists, and giving you the ability to showcase to the world your ideas, your products, and your solutions. So this is a major initiative that we have taken now in the state of Andhra Pradesh. Apart from that, as Chaudhary Garu has just said, you know, Chaudhary Garu, I call him the grandfather of Indian IT. He has a lot of energy. Young grandfather, I'm corrected. Young grandfather of Indian IT. So Chaudhary Garu is the man who has played a very instrumental role in kickstarting the entire IT revolution in Hyderabad. It was the Honorable Chief Minister and Chaudhary Garu who had series of meetings, I think almost 25-30 meetings, to get that one building, which is icon, Cyber Tower, going. So Chaudhary Garu and I, you know, we kept talking about it. I said, you know, as Andhra Pradesh, we need to take a position. And he said, we'll take a position in fintech. And under his leadership, we have done this million-dollar challenge, where we've showcased to the world, you know, all the great companies across the globe can actually come, take part in this million-dollar challenge, and actually win $1 million. And this was done in the fintech festival in Vishakhapatnam, I think exactly 10 days back. So this is where, you know, we have done this amazing work. We're also now doing a two-nation hackathon. We're working with partners in Israel, where companies from Andhra Pradesh can go there and vice versa. We can actually learn from their ecosystem. They can learn from us. As Chaudhary Garu already said, you know, we're working with London, we're working with Hong Kong, we're working with the Bay Area. The whole idea is we want to give you a platform for young minds here to actually showcase your talents globally. And this is one of the biggest initiatives that we've taken in the state of Andhra Pradesh. Apart from that, the Honorable Chief Minister, as part of the Gyanaberi program, has been coming to a lot of colleges, a lot of universities, and actually talking about this. As part of this program, he announced that he's going to give 10 crores per district per year. That's 130 crore rupees to fund your ideas. It could be 10,000 rupees, 50,000 rupees, it could be 1 lakh, 5 lakhs, 10 lakhs. To take your, you know, the idea all the way through to a pilot or a product. And this is where we want to now create a robust ecosystem, and we'll be launching the platform soon. Apart from that, of course, we're working with the Government of India. We got the largest number of Atal Tinkering Labs. I believe that that's just the beginning. In my recent review, I also said cyber security. You know, again, all the representatives from colleges are here. We request you to throw open your labs. We are going to give you all the tools so that you can skill the students up. You can build courses around cyber security. You know, as a state, we're working with the industry, we're working with the private sector to understand where are the new opportunities. It could be cyber security, machine learning, artificial intelligence. We understand that. And as a state, we want to then enable colleges like you to offer these courses to the students. If required, even actually do an entire curriculum around next generation technologies. And I would request you to actually be part of this entire ecosystem. You know, apart from this, I'm living a dream. And for me, that is what makes my job very exciting. And my dream is that in the next 5 years, at least 10 unicorns should come from the state of Andhra Pradesh. Now comes the tough question. How many of you know what a unicorn is? Because I didn't know. So a unicorn is a company that has a market value of $1 billion. And the way rupee is going, I think it will go to about 8,000 crores. So 8,000 crore should be the market value of each of these companies. And we have taken a stand that we can actually do 10 such companies in the next 5 years. And when I gave this idea, a lot of people asked me, they pushed back, they said, how is this possible? So I gave them a few examples. I said, globally, if you come across 10 IT professionals, globally, 10 IT professionals, 4 are from India. And out of that 4, 1 is from the state of Andhra Pradesh. 10%. Which means 10% of the global IT workforce is actually from the state of Andhra Pradesh. You know, they've conquered companies. You know, in fact, when I was doing my US trip and I went to Cerner Healthcare in Kansas City, it was at 6:30 in the morning, we had a meeting and 30 people from Andhra Pradesh were waiting at the door for me. Then when I went to Amazon Web Services in Seattle, you know, from the boardroom to the lift lobby on my way back, I came across 20 people from the state of Andhra Pradesh. So talent is here. We have sent the talent globally. Now the opportunity has come to harness that energy in the state of Andhra Pradesh, to harness this, to give you an opportunity to build amazing startup companies. You know, apart from that, many people ask me this question. They say, how come Panchayat Raj, Rural Development and IT is under the same minister? So I keep telling them this. I said, my job is to marry Bharat and India. And how technology can be used for the masses. And this is where I strongly believe that each ministry plays a very, very important role. So after I became a minister, we've done a few interesting works in my own department, and I'll share that with you. The first one is road quality. Though Andhra has much better roads than any other state in India, but the Honorable Chief Minister keeps telling me that there has to be a pothole-free road. You know, Panchayat Raj roads should be pothole-free. Zero potholes. I think that's a great vision, but how do I execute it? So I gave this challenge. I gave this challenge to quite a few of the startups, and one company from Bangalore actually cracked it. So we are now using drones with LiDAR to map the quality of roads, to geotag every pothole, to give me the length, width, depth of every pothole, and to actually automate the entire process even till tendering. So the drone flies, it gives me feedback, till tendering it's automated. And through this, our agenda is that twice a year, we want to map all the Panchayat Raj roads, all the R&B roads, all the municipal roads. So this is where I think, a very, very important technology innovation. No one's done it globally. I thought someone would have cracked it. Clearly, no one's done it. And we from the state of Andhra Pradesh are actually doing this. The other problem that I struggled was with rural drinking water.